Yeah, bro. I can't imagine what you're going through. But I'm definitely going to keep you in my mind, your family. I got family members that aren't conscious. To a degree, they have goodwill, but the reason why we never meet on those terms of goodwill is because of communication. I found that when I don't communicate with my family members, that they form an opinion. I also find that some family members that I do communicate with on a regular basis have formed an opinion of me. However, I'm not accountable for how they feel about me. I'm only accountable for how I feel about them. They have my condolences. Just basically, man, like, stay strong. The fact that you didn't fill out the Social Security papers where that little red number at the bottom of the birth certificates and stuff, you know, goes right up on the stock exchange. You're already collateral. You're already cashed out, you know. And the fact that you didn't fill out those forms on those contracts means that your child was not a ward of the state. I don't know what that means to you, your brother, but your child is not a ward of the state. If you didn't contractually agree or have any agreements with the government in regards of your child's birthing, because birthing is deals with maritime law, born out of water. That's where these things come from. And when you don't make yourself a commercial entity, then they have no ties to you. Deal with common law or UCC law, Uniform Commercial Code. You know, you don't have to deal with those municipalities, statutes and codes and ordinances and things like that. If you're dealing with common law, those things are what were called color of law. Anybody can ask any lawyer. These things are called color of law. And you have my positive energy, good brother. Once again, like I said, man, you already have all you need. And it's only an ultimate realization that your family members who are not conscious, they will become conscious. It will be inevitable, that upward state. And the blessing is that Mensa has reached a higher conscious before them, because we are conscious, and we're just occupying this matter, if that's what we're going to call it. But whatever love you manifest during the times that you shared, definitely real. And things that are real, that are created out of love, resonate. And this resonation is, to me, is the basis of everything. You know, something has to power all of this stuff, even the bad things. You know, something, or what we would see as bad, something has to power it all. And to me, that force behind all that power is love. You know, it allows everything to be in the state that it is. And that love that you shared with your baby man and your family, that's all that really matters. It's all that really matters. And I feel you, you know, family's going to come at you. You know, they're in turmoil as well. You know, they're probably torn apart as well. And the fact that you're staying strong despite the fiery darts that are coming at you, you know, to and fro, it's just coming at you all over the place, man. You know, and in this at this present moment that time that you're going through is a testament to your own strength. And if you need to be fortified with my good positive feedback, you got it. You got that. You know, honestly, earnestly, diligently, and I'll help you fortify whatever it is you need to fortify, good brother. You know, like I said, I just find it interesting that some of our family members would go to a position of a hurtful position rather than a helpful position, you know, because considering your loss, you know, I would be there to support. So it must be some type of generalization or judgment that they're passing on you, which is predicating their actions. So, you know, I mean, if we all would see things in the love aspect or see things, you know, mercifully and deal with things mercifully and not with such severity and bias, because we don't know everything. You know, I used to think blue was blue until somebody explained to me that blue is not blue. You know, it's just like that. And but that like I say, man, that love that you share with Mensa, man, is the most important thing, and it's true on a fractal level. I mean, even if we bring it down to like that resonance, that sound and that giving force. Like you take a trumpet, you blow into a trumpet, you hear air. When you give it frequency, you buzz your lips and you put something into it, it resonates and reverberates on itself and creates a tone. And that resonance is what sustains everything. To me, it's kind of like how the electrons know where they are, or knows where it is at all times with everything, or something like that. It's like a law that is just in place, and it works on all levels, you know. And, that reverbing, that coming back, that matching of frequencies, or, you know, that, what is it, cavitation, whatever they call it. These things are the only things that last. So I would like to contribute to the love that you shared. You have my sympathy and my compassion and my deepest, most profound, positive encouragement that I could possibly render. So, you know, it's much love, real love. Like some people say, God is love. To me, you know, what's, you know, is the equal sign. What's on one side of the equal sign equals exactly what's on the other equal sign. You know, God is love. That's it. You know, and whatever love you share, that was a gift from God. Because it was so precious and so meaningful, you know, it was fulfilling. So the pain can easily be flip-flopped into pleasurable moments because of your perception. And brother, I've always enjoyed your perception and how you feel about things. Don't change. I'm going to be positive for you.